Hey yo, check it out. You're now rocking with the best. It's your boy Big Star Raw Sports. Thank y'all for tuning in to another classic episode of Big Star's Lost Tapes. You know what I'm saying? Quick shout out to everybody who's been supporting the Raw Sports movement. In particular, while we're here, everybody who's been feeling and appreciating and showing me mad love for the Lost Tapes that I'll be putting out there, you know, collecting from all across the country. Special episode right here. It's definitely going down. One of my goals and ultimate dreams for this segment of the website, rawsports.tv, Big Stars Lost Tapes, is to actually link up with the legends that we feature on the episodes. So my ultimate goal is to be sitting here with Bo Kemble, to be sitting here with Donnie Carr, you know, to be sitting here with Kobe Bryant, you know, talking about their career, talking about the history, then having them do their own intro, you know, to the Lost Tape. But whenever I can't make that happen, you know, we definitely gonna, you know, go back to the old school and, you know, just get cats live, you know, to do a little phone interview, you know what I'm saying? So without any further ado, I'm gonna get my man Howard Brown, the legend. I don't wanna get, you know, too much in his career, you know, telling his story, but I'm gonna get Brown on the line, you know what I'm saying, live, so he can, you know, shout out to the people, you know what I mean, give a little bit of his own history and do a little intro to the Lost Tape we about to get into. Brown, what's the deal, big dog?
Big Star, what's going on, baby?
I'm chilling, big homie. Hey, listen, speak to the people, man. You live, man. You now rocking with the best officially, man. It's Big Star's Lost Tapes featuring the legend, Howard Brown. Speak to the people. We live on the air, big dog.
Oh, much love to all the fans out there. You know, Big Star, you doing your thing, man. You doing your thing. I just talking to my people about you. You know, yesterday we were watching that Bron game, that high school game, that was on the chain, man. We love what you doing.
Hey, appreciate it, Brown, man. You know, we all have something in common, you know, which is this game that we all love, man. And, you know, I just feel it's my duty to give, you know, this is my interpretation. This is, you know, this is my contribution to the culture, man. And once, you know, portion of the culture that, you know, not too many people focus on is where it all began, man. You know what I'm saying? So that's why I'm so excited about the Lost Tapes section of the website, you know, because it's like, dog, like, we have so much history, one, just here in PA, but beyond, man, like, you know, high school hoops, you know, playgrounds, that's where it all started at, man. And that's my passion. That's what I love to do, man. So I appreciate your support and, you know, help me to do what it is that I do, man. Alright, so real quick, for the younger viewers who are checking out the video right now, and, you know, all the OGs, you know, just remind them, you know, give an official introduction of yourself, you know, just introduce yourself to the people and where you come from.
I know that Howard Brown, start back in Pottstown, born and raised, 1993 state champion, 95 player of the year in the state of Pennsylvania. Kobe Bryant was in that class. So, you know, what Howard Brown is about, you know, went back from Pottstown straight to Villanova, 4 years there. Hit one of the biggest shots of my career at Madison Square Garden. I don't know if you remember that. The East tournament, double overtime, game winner. And then played overseas, man, for 13 years. Just truly a blessing. Each year I would come back, start a nonprofit in my hometown, just invest financial resources, college grounds for the athletes. And now we're here, still in human services, and also, you know, running a sports agency called iBall United, just trying to get back and help these young guys along so they can, you know, see some of the blessings that I would be able to see over my career and, you know, stand on the shoulders of giants and go beyond, you know, where I could take it.
That's what's up. Hey, real quick, let's flash back real quick to your high school days. Just let the people know, man, why I consider you a legend, man. You know, and you seem real humble, man. So, you know, you seem like the type of cat that don't really want to brag on yourself. So, if you want to, you can leave that up to me. I'll brag on you all day because I seen the legend. I seen the legend at work. I seen you jumping, skying, like, you know what I'm saying, like Vince Carter. I seen it with my own eyes, you know what I'm saying? But if you can, real quick, give the people, you know, tell the people a little bit about, you know, some of your high school accomplishments and, you know, things that you were, you know, getting into those days.
Well, you know, back then it was just all about winning for the city of Pottstown, man. Just came up under Coach Davis and a really great culture of winning. And just another kid from the neighborhood that just wanted to bring a championship and really close-knit group of guys. I mean, Tom Harvey, you know, my man Marcus Ricketts, Mike, great, you know, we stuck together in a lot of different sports, just always trying to win, and that's what it was all about to us, man, just playing the game the way, you know, we knew how to play and doing what it took to contribute to a team, so that, you know, at the end of the game, we came out victorious. So, you know, from there, I was, you know, Pac-10 player of the year a few times, regional player of the year, won the Pac-10 championship, our league championship. Each year, three-time District 1 champion, two-time Eastern Regional Conference champion, and then the 93 state championship, and then been player of the year PA. So, you know, still all those accolades come with just the everyday grind of getting up and putting in the work. And that's what we're all about, man. We just love to play. We love to play for each other and you know, and win. That's what it's all about.
That's what's up. Hey, real quick, describe your game. Like when people will come out to see the Howard Brown, you know, Tom Harvey show, like, you know, what would they see and leaving the gym that night, what do you think the conversations would be like? Like with a big game for Howard Brown?
Big game for Howard Brown is pretty much a little bit of everything. A little bit of everything. And then to cap it off, we had to do a little bit of high flying, catching an alley, my man Tom Harvey, throwing for half court, maybe catch it backwards, that kind of stuff. But just, you know, every minute that I'm on court, just going for the loose ball, playing defense, just everything that we're trying to do is to grind out and win the game. You know, smart decisions, you know, fundamentally sound, you know, things of that nature. But like I said, you know, I love to put on a show, and then a lot of that came from, you know, taking off and. Person, I used to, you know, like to say, I had the VIP to the penthouse, right? And press the button, the elevator will always come to the sky high. You know?
Definitely. Hey, you know, one of the things that I really enjoy just about being born when I was born and graduating high school when I graduated, the 95, like the 90s in general, dog, in the state of PA had it going on. Let the people know some of the individuals that, you know, were a part of your era, you know, some of the cats, you know, some of the big names you played against, whether it was during the season, you know, summertime, all-star games, whatever it is. Let the people know, like, the level that was in PA around that time.
Yeah, like I said, man, you talk about Kobe Bryant, man, you know, one of the greatest, if not the greatest, to ever do it, man. You know, and then from there, you got the Rasheed Wallace, you got the whole Philly crew, even with my guy, Alan Williams, and Jason Lawson, you know, and then out on the west, you got a guy named Tom Pitkin. And just everywhere, man, players, people, you know, they love basketball. I've never seen Rasheed Wallace when we went to the meet the senator for the state championship, and we didn't get a chance to play against the city league. We thought we could compete. You know, everybody was just all about the sport, all about the love of the game. And then you come out, you know, my class, Rasheed Brokerboro, you know, Wayne Greer was a young guy coming up. I mean, the guys he had at Mayo, he had a lot of guys, you know, all across, you know, not just Philly, the suburbs of Philly, but all across PA that were monster players and went on to do some big things.
That's what's up, man. Real quick, you touched on.
What's going on, man?
I know.
I mean, I used to go to the City League Championship every year with my brother and play, and, you know, look at the end of the celestial, seeing that going on. We had a lot of conversations. We could keep going on and off the stage, Rick Hamilton. Wow.
tons of names, right? Hey, real quick. So you played at Villanova. You had an amazing career at Villanova. And then you went overseas. Let me know about the European, you know, just you know, everything. Just real quick about your overseas experience.
Yeah, so, you know, coming out of Nova, didn't really have, you know, the high power Asian knocking on my door, so it was a learning experience for me. I did get a chance to try out for the Golden State Warriors, try out for the Nets, you know, one of the last cuts for the Jersey Nets, my first year out, and I found myself, you know, kind of bouncing around from league to league here in the U.S. Just a tough journey, man, but about a year and a half later, I was able to get my teeth, right, into an agent overseas in Spain, and, you know, got my opportunity to go over there and show what I could do, and led the league in scoring, you know, first team all the league, and from there, now I was able to learn the game, really appreciate the game, really appreciate the coaches and the experience, and play, you know, two championships over there in Spain. I actually played, you know, majority of my years in Spain, but had an opportunity to play in Portugal, Israel, Venezuela, bounce around a little bit in Italy. So just totally a blessing, man, and met my wife, had my son over there, and really embraced the whole experience, but at the same time, understand that it was a blessing. Unfortunately, the Nation stay around for 13 years, so, you know, just want to come back and help guys along this way, along this journey.
That's what's up. That's what's up, man. I appreciate hearing that. Hey, what is what we gonna do? We gonna go ahead and get into the game. So and then at the very, you know, at the end of the game, we gonna wrap it up. So if you can give an official introduction into the game, let the people know, you know, just break it down. Say, yo, this is Howard Brown. You know, you watching Big Stars Lost Tapes, and the game you about to see is Pottstown. You know, just break it down. You the host for the day. Yo, Brown, you a beast, dog. You officially rocking with the best. You my new co-host, dog. Hey, we're going to get into it. Big Stars Lost Tapes. Big Stars Lost Tapes, man. We about to get into it, man. Pottstown, Phoenixville. Check it out.
Stadium at Pottstown Senior High School. PCTV Sports presents Pac-10 Basketball. Tonight, the Pottstown Trojans host the Phoenixville Phantoms. Good evening, everybody. This is Dick Geiger along with Dave Ridenour. And Dave, I guess we're into the meat of the schedule in the Pac-10. And tonight, PCTV's serving up a big steak because we've got the top two teams in the Pac-10.
Certainly do, Dick. And I think the game lost a little bit of luster in some of the people's eyes when O&J knocked off Phoenixville. A lot of people thought the fans and the Trojans were going to lock up here. Both of them undefeated.
Well, tonight's teams pose some interesting matchups in a man-to-man situation. Maybe you can go over some of those matchups.
Well, the big one's going to be Brown and Illig, obviously. They're the two marquee players on both sides. I think Phoenixville will have a little bit of advantage with Ramsey and Miller. Harper and Morgan and Martin are really going to have to play big tonight to match up with the big people inside.
What about the depth category? Phoenixville could have a little bit more depth in the case of foul trouble.
They could, you know. I mean, we haven't seen them too much, Dick. You know, I don't know how deep they want to go in their bench in a big game. That's the key. We saw them against Pius. They had their way with St. Pius, so they went deep into their bench. George Rocker wants to play his top six, seven guys, and I think what concerns him more than anything else, Dick, is the fact that Pottstown has played in a lot more big games than his Phantoms have.
Okay, we're also seeing two of the best defensive teams in the league, and that could result in a low-scoring game. Who does that benefit?
Well, I think that benefits the team who's shooting the ball better from the outside, be it Phoenixville, be it Pottstown. You know, have to see how that goes. I think a key interesting matchup also is going to be the point guards, to see how they match up tonight, because Tom Harvey, we know what he can do. We'll see what the point guard from Phoenixville does tonight and how he responds to that pressure.
Okay, the two top teams in the Pac-10, Hook Horns tonight. We'll be back with the play-by-play right after this. And you can look at some of the captains at midcourt shaking hands. And in our pregame, we mentioned some of the interesting matchups in which tonight's game presents. And Gus down the trunk did a good job of presenting those to
us. Yeah, there's one interesting one right there with Tom Ramsey at about 6'5", and John Harper giving Pottstown some size inside at 6'2". Ben Morgan and Corey Miller, again, two guys are going to do the dirty work inside. We saw Corey Miller over St. Pius really do a nice job of posting inside, Richard. A big key also would be the point guards, Terrell Morris, who's a little bit taller and bigger than Tom Harvey, but Tom Harvey with that quickness and that experience is what's going to be the key. We'll see how Terrell Morris handles that pressure early on. And in a marquee matchup that we talked about, two of the better athletes in the Pac-10, Howard Brown already signed to go to Villanova to play basketball, Brett Illig going the baseball route, going down south, and you got the two best dunkers in the league right there, Dick, and that's going to be an interesting matchup.
And we mentioned that both of the teams are in the 1 and 2 spots in the Pac-10. Phoenixville having only one loss to O&J. Pottstown undefeated in the Pac-10.
Dick, what do you think about that loss that Phoenixville has? How is that going to affect them coming in tonight? Do you see it?
Well, I don't think it will. I think George Rocco knows the significance of this game and is going to be able to get his team up. And, you know, if his team has any basketball players on it, it's absolutely no trouble for his squad to get up for a game like this in this gym.
Whatever my thoughts exactly, Dick. You know, we talked to a lot of people coming into the ball game, and as I said in the top of the show, a lot were surprised that Phoenixville was knocked off by O&J. Give Ted Snyder and his group a lot of credit over there. They really jumped up and played very well, especially in the second half, to pull that ball game out. Both teams had aspirations of coming into this one undefeated and really hooking up, but I don't think that game will have a lot of bearing as you get a good look at Ken Davis. He's been down this road many, many times, but I'm sure he still has those butterflies in his stomach.
All right, now we're going to set it down to the floor and the PA announcer.
Every Sunday morning at 11 o'clock on Channel 17. Now, each week on the show, Burger King sponsors a male and female athlete of the week. Last week, Pottstown star Howard Brown was named male athlete of the week by Burger King.
According to the Inquirer, and also Burger King has a hand in that one, Richard.
And we'll take a brief timeout. We'll be right back with the play-by-play. There's our tonight's officials, Mike Plunkett and Tommy Katanchik on the right.
Two veterans, and we've seen those two guys many, many times, and I think both coaches, George Rocco and Ken Davis, are very happy with they got two good, solid officials tonight as you get a good look at the starting lineups, Richard.
Terrell Morris, Adam Blackburn, Tom Ramsey, Corey Miller, and Brett Illig. And for Pottstown, they go with Brown, Harvey, Martin, Ben Morgan, and John Harper. And it could be a record crowd on hand for the Strom Gymnasium anyway.
Absolutely.
Really a packed house here tonight. Phoenixville controls the tap. Adam Blackburn.
Matched up with T.C. Martin.
T.C. Martin. Yep. Pottstown does come out in man-to-man. Now we got a traveling violation.
See, there's the one key for the Phantoms. Again, there's that a little nervous jitters inside. But, you know, with Blackburn handling the ball a lot, you know, that's going to put a lot of pressure on him. Even though Keith Martin, again, is another young guy who hasn't had a whole lot of big game experience, it's going to put a lot of pressure on Blackburn handling the rock that much.
Now, Coach Davis told me before the game that Harvey's knee is bothering him a little bit and that Ben Morgan not quite 100% tonight, although both obviously in the starting lineup.
It's going to take a little more than a bumper or a bruise to keep guys out of this ball game. Phoenixville in a 2-3 zone right now, going to make Pottstown beat him from the outside.
Harvey will take the three. It's off the front of the rim. Harper with the follow, and he's fouled.
That's what
John Harper gets inside position.
That's where they have to get out of number 42 as he crashes the boards, and Corey Miller pick up his first foul. Tom Harvey getting a good look at the basket from the wing. Harper doing a good job rotating in from the weak side, and there's the hit on the arm by number 44, Miller.
John Harper steps to the line. And Pottstown has the lead. 1-0. Two nothing ball game. Harper knocks down both free throws.
You know, it's funny, Dick. I'm looking around at the crowd, and this is what high school sports is all about right here. On a Tuesday night, no better place to be than Strum Gymnasium. Check out the Phantoms and the Trojans. There's a good matchup right there. Brown and Illig, two Division I athletes. Villanova could have used Howard Brown last night. They lost a squeaker up the Carrier Dome. Yeah.
Keithy Martin with the block, but he also draws the foul.
Late whistle by Mike Plunkett there also. Looked like Martin had a block and the Trojans are ready to go the other way with it. Good weak side rotation. Illig does a good job of spotting up down low, and there's a lot of ball there.
Corey Miller steps to the line. He'll be shooting too. That one is left well short.
Well, again, there's those jitters that I talked about. It's what George Rocco was concerned when I talked to him. He said, my Phantoms have not been in near as many big games as the Trojans have. They're more used to the big crowd and the big ball games. Good second shot, though, by Corey Miller. He took a deep breath and knocked it down.
2-1 ball game. Now Phoenixville starts a three-quarter court press. Lazy pass. Brown controls it. And now Phoenixville settles into that 2-3 zone.
And it's not bad when you have a 6-3 guy out front of the 2-3 zone. It can really alter shots.
Martin gets in the lane, puts up a shot. Ben Morgan and Ramsey get a jump ball going.
Possession arrow in favor of the Trojans.
Trojans will have possession.
There's our buddy down there, Tom Ramsey Jr. His pop on the handheld down on the floor.
It's got to be a tough job. Really.
Yeah, it certainly does.
Father to have his son in the ball game. And
can't be cheering, that's for sure.
Can't clap too many times. Harper down the lane, puts it high off the glass. Harper has the first field goal of the contest.
Well, these are the kind of games where some of the role players, Dick, can really step up and play well because everybody's paying attention to the Browns and Harveys and Illigs on the floor, and some of the role players can step up and have huge, huge ball games. And there's a travel.
Yep, Terrell Morris drugged a pivot foot. Second turnover by Phoenixville.
Certainly not the way George Rocco wanted to start this one. He wanted his club to be settled down. He didn't want to hype it up too much. He didn't want the kids to be all excited. I think they got to get the ball in number 31's hands, Illig. He's a guy who's been there before. He's a guy that's going down south to play Division I ball. He should be able to handle the rock fairly well.
.550 left to play in the first quarter. 4-1 Trojans.
Good weak side help there by Morris.
Three-pointer by Harvey goes down. Tom Harvey gets Trojans on top 7-1. This is an important possession for the Phantoms. They
sure
need a good
is.
Shot at the basket.
Yes, they do. And that's the guy I'd keep the ball in his hands right there, number 31. Even though Brown's covering him, I'd make Brown work real hard on the defensive end.
Good job by...
Yes, it was. Ben Morgan doing a
Morgan.
Good job.
Good defense on Adam Blackburn, pokes it out of bounds, and the finish does not get off the shot at the basket. They trail 7-1. I'm not sure they have a field goal attempt in this ballgame. That one shot was blocked.
That blocked, right. And Keith Martin thought he had a lot of ball on that block.
Brown feeds Harper. He loses the handle, but it's run down by Martin.
Brown doing a good job of being unselfish there as everybody's collapsing on number 22. George Rocco has definitely come in here with the idea that he was not going to beat us.
Harper from the top of the key, nothing but net, but it's a deuce. Harper has 6 points here in the first quarter, and Phoenixville needs a timeout. They get a timeout with 4:53 left to play in the first quarter. Get ready for the Super Bowl with the help of the Farmers Market at Limerick. Order your sandwiches and deli trays from Sonny's Deli, shrimp trays from Jab's Seafood, and veggie trays from Landis Run Farm Market. And the Farmers Market at Limerick has something for you Super Bowl widows, too. Visit the Horse and Buggy Yarn Shop or Wee Bairns for some great craft ideas. Come visit us at the Limerick, at the Farmers Market at Limerick. It's open Sundays from 10 till 3.
And we talked about the crowd, Dick, and they're still filing in. Everybody's going to have to take a deep breath and move to the right about 6 inches to try to pack some more people in, as there's all kinds of people down at both ends waiting to get into the ball game. It's kind of reminiscent of our Thanksgiving Day effort at down at Springford when Springford and Phoenixville played a big ball game, and it was standing room only, over 10,000 people. But I'll tell you right now, those guys have been here since 4:30 reserving those seats.
They had to get here early.
Absolutely. Great to see those guys year in and year out make it, doesn't it?
9-1 ball game. Phoenixville again comes away with a very poor possession. In fact, Adam Blackburn picks up a foolish foul.
Well, I think a frustration foul more so than anything, Dick, is the fact that Martin really did a good job of playing defense. Blackburn had a travel violation. He lost the handle of the ball. He's not settled into the ball game right now, as George Rocco's telling him, just to settle down and move the basketball.
8-point ball game. Pottstown breaks the pressure. Howard Brown sets up for the three. He can't make it. Ben Morgan has good position. He and Ramsey fight for the rebound. That's going to be Phoenixville ball.
Well, Ben Morgan's doing a nice heady job so far. He's getting in the open spots. He's 6 inches shorter than Ramsey inside. He gives up a lot of weight inside to Corey Miller, but he's in there banging and almost snuck an offensive rebound as Howard Brown was this short on his first 3-point try of the night.
Illig on Brown. Dumps into Blackburn. Blackburn forces one up. Corey Miller's in there for the rebound and the follow.
Good job by number 44, Miller.
Corey Miller has all three of Phoenixville's points. 9-3, Pottstown.
Phoenixville's going to stay in the zone, make Pottstown beat him from the outside.
Harper shot off the mark, but Howard Brown's there for the tip. Howard Brown has his first field goal, and it's 11-3, Trojans.
Boy, is his game really advancing, isn't it, Dick? He's really coming on strong. As we saw in as our pregame, is he was named the Inquirer Player of the Month, received another nice award. That's off Illig's knee. Yes, sir.
Trojan ball.
And they're playing good team defense right now. They're very, very aware of where Illig is on the floor as well. As he had Howard beat down the sideline, but Ben Morgan and Keith Martin stepped in and caused him to dribble off his knee.
John Harper getting his shoes laced up.
Chatting with Mike Plunk a little bit. That's the kind of guy Harper is. He's a funny guy. He'll be talking to people down inside.
Well, they really collapsed on Brown. Four guys around him when he touched the ball. Harvey's shot is strong. We've got a whistle underneath. I think it's on Brown.
From a mile away, Mike Plunkett saw that when Howard Brown tried to get away with one. He thought he had the official in the other corner to get away with a little push inside. I thought Keith Martin actually pushed.
First team foul on Brown.
or first personal on Brown, second team foul. John Harper pokes it away. Morris gets it to Miller. He's going to go right in. Back to Blackburn. His shot's off the mark. Harvey has it. Outlet to Howard Brown.
Showtime!
Rim shaker, Howard Brown.
Showtime! He and Brett Illig, the two best dunkers in the league. Howard's one up on him, 1-0.
10-point advantage for the Trojans.
Pottstown looks very, very active tonight. Phoenixville, again, very apprehensive in what they want to do. They're trying to slow it down. Pottstown trying to speed it up.
Blackburn's left wide open. He can't make the shot. Illig with a big rebound. Goes strong to the hole. He's fouled.
That's going to be two on Keith Martin. We'll see what Coach Davis' strategy. He's got Marcus Ricketts. He's got Brandon Tinson. Howard Brown's ready for this one, though, baby. He's pumped up. Can you believe that's a high school kid, though, Dick? You know, I remember we were in school. We got a guy who used to touch the rim. Everybody get all pumped up. Let's get rim. Let's get rim. This guy's up to his elbows. Tom Harvey, again, always with his eyes up, and Howard Brown up to his elbows. He's pointing to the Inquirer people. He loves it. These kids are unbelievable, the way they play basketball, and any athlete, really, in high school today, they're so far advanced with the strength and speed and size.
We have a first substitution in the ballgame as Marcus Ricketts comes in, and along with Brandon Tinson.
Well, I'll tell you right now, both guys that are sitting on the bench for Pottstown a little bit deserve a break. They're really doing a good job. Ben Morgan and Keith Martin doing a nice job here in the first quarter. Chris Nessie's going to check in also for Adam Blackburn. Blackburn needs to relax a little bit. I think I put too much pressure on with my diaper dandy pick last year.
Brandon Tinson gets caught in the corner while he picked up his dribble.
Exactly. My thoughts, do not pick your dribble up, especially in the corner there. You get stuck. This is a big game for Brandon Tinson. He's been playing a lot better. Coach Davis has been getting him a lot of valuable PT. He's got to really step up.
13-5 Trojans. 2 minutes left to play in the first quarter. Inside to Ricketts. He turns to the bucket. Can't find iron with that one.
Good rebound by Tom Ramsey. However, that is a good shot for Marcus Ricketts. He can make that shot. He just kind of lost his bearing where he was on the floor, and he threw it hard off the backboard.
Nesky feeds it inside to Ramsey. He and Ricketts fight for it, and that ball will belong to Phoenixville.
From the floor in the first quarter, Phoenixville only getting off three shots, shooting 33%. Pottstown 5-for-10.
Illig drops the ball. Tom Harvey pushes it ahead. Illig chases him down and commits a foul. Non-shooting foul.
Again, frustration on Brett Illig. He wants to get off in this game badly, too. You can see him. He's talking to his buddies a little bit. Looks over to Coach Rocco. Get another look at Tom Harvey out in front of the pack, and there's the foul by Brett Illig.
Phoenixville stays in the zone defense. They trail by 8 in this contest.
Oh, nice
look. Nice dish to Tinson. Finally gets the shot off and puts it off the glass.
See, that's, again, part of that unselfishness that Howard Brown is really starting to develop. Not that he was unselfish, but he gives the ball off inside. Even though he's the big scorer, the big Division I player, he gets the rock inside to his buddy Brandon Tinson. Good break of pressure right there.
Corey Miller stripped from behind. And Howard Brown will set up the half-court offense. That's off Phoenixville, trying to get into John Harper.
Harper having a huge first quarter with 6 points, doing his job. Garbage man, banging inside, knocked in an outside shot.
Poked out of bounds by Terrell Morris. And Pottstown will inbound one more time. 44 seconds left in the first quarter.
Joaquin Fordbay checks in to give Tom Ramsey a blow at 44 seconds. Good move by George Rocco. Get Tom Ramsey 44 seconds here, plus the break in between quarters. Try to keep him fresh for the second period. This is the kind of game, Dick, where you're more tired in the first period because of all the nervous energy that you have.
And Fordbay creates a steal. At Neske with the ball. 25 seconds left in the quarter. See if Phoenixville can get off a good shot here. Neske will take it from the corner baseline. Fort Bay is stripped by Tom Harvey.
Alley-oop. Oh, that's a good play by Neske. Great play by Chris Neske.
He hustled back and he saw it coming.
Yep. I can see it coming too. I saw Tom Harvey and Howard Brown making eye contact, and Howard was flying down that right wing. Give Chris Neske a lot of credit on that play because he didn't give up on it.
7 seconds left. Brown, top of the key, three-pointer. Rebound comes to Harvey. He can't make it. Brown at the buzzer.
It goes.
I count it.
Yes.
Count the bucket. That will end the first quarter. And on the Spence Ford scoreboard, it's Pottstown 17, Phoenixville 5. We'll be right back.
There's the cameraman from Channel 17 out of Philadelphia. Here checking all Howard Brown and the Athlete of the Month. They got, even have a Villanova sweatshirt on.
He does.
Real nice ceremony before the game. Burger King presented Howard Brown with a nice plaque.
Terrell Morris with some aggressive defense, pokes it away. Brown picks it up and will start the half-court offense. John Harper travels with the ball.
I thought he stepped out of bounds before he traveled with it. This is a good hustle by the guy off the bench, number 10, Chris Neske, as Harvey tried to set up the alley-oop, and Neske does a great job of hustling back and getting that block, or there would have been another slam, and that would have gotten the Pottstown people all fired up.
Phoenixville trails by 12. We're about a minute into the second quarter. Morris improves his position, but can't get the shot down. And then he pokes it out of bounds. That's Pottstown ball.
Well, see, there's where Marcus Rickus has to get the ball with two hands, Dick, and protect. You don't throw your elbows, but you got to keep your elbows out. That's good hustle by number 13, Morris, inside. I'm surprised Phoenixville is staying in this zone. I thought they'd have to come out and play a little man, try to pick up the tempo, get back into ball games. They're down 12 points going into the second period.
Harper gets alone in the baseline, but he travels again. He forgot to put the ball on the floor. Pottstown turns it over again.
But the thing is, Phoenixville's not taking advantage of those turnovers. Pottstown turned it over the last two trips down the floor, and Phoenixville hasn't been able to cash it in. There's another unforced turnover as Ford Bay loses concentration. You know, that's that intensity that you must play with for all four quarters, 32 minutes here tonight in this kind of ball game. I think Ramsey's going to come in and check out Ford Bay.
Joaquin Ford Bay will take a seat on the bench. I was wondering the same, Dave, as how long Phoenixville can stay in this zone defense.
Well, George Rocco's electing to stay in it probably a little bit longer than I would think most coaches would stay in, or I guess I would, I don't know. It's George's style. He probably feels he doesn't match up well with him offensively, doesn't want to get in a run-and-gun game with him, but down 14 points in the second period here, he's going to have to do something sooner or later to change things up.
Howard Brown knocks down the little jumper. Again, Phoenixville turns it over without a shot at the basket. Brandon Tinson with the left hand at the other end.
That's a good look by John Harper again. Pottstown very unselfish and are running the floor extremely well here tonight.
Tinson now has 4 points. Illig gives up to Neske. Terrell Morris,
Peace,
partially blocked by Tom Harvey. Brown to Harvey. He can't make it. Nice block. Illig and Neske hustle back and make the block, and that's going to be Phoenixville ball.
Good hustle by Phoenixville getting back defensively. Saved an easy two there as Tom Harvey got caught up inside underneath the basket. Harvey doing a good job, again, trying to avoid the block. Looked like Ramsey got a piece of that ball, but Mike Plunkett says no, off Marcus Ricketts. Now Pottstown can sit back in a 2-3 zone and make Phoenixville try to beat him from the outside.
Ramsey puts one up, and he's going to be fouled by Marcus Ricketts. Marcus sent Ramsey to the line to shoot two.
Marcus thought he had pretty good position inside. One thing Tom Ramsey did there that's not real good for a big man, he brought the ball down real low, is Tom Harvey almost got a strip. When you're 6'5", you got to keep that ball up at shoulder height so those little guards can't double down on you and strip the ball. Tom Ramsey real lucky to get that one back.
Yeah. Tom leaves that one short.
Got to get your legs in there a little bit. Looked a little stiff in the upper body. Bend your knees a little bit, Tommy. Take a deep breath and knock it home. There we go.
He makes one of two, and it's now a 21-6 ball game. 5:20 left to play in the second.
Now Phoenixville's going to extend their defense a little bit. Marcus thought about it. There's a shot.
Tom Harvey takes the three. Nothing but net. Tom Harvey has two field goals in the contest, both of them three-pointers.
You know, that's what I like about Tom Harvey so much as a point guard, Dick, is he knows when to distribute the basketball, knows when to give it up, and knows when to shoot the rock. And that's what he has really improved on, and that's why I say he's the premier point guard in our area, bar none.
Brett Illig from the top of the key gets a friendly roll here at the Strom Gymnasium, and Brett Illig has his first field goal.
Pottstown very patient, facing his pressure.
Howard Brown from three, he drops it in. And it's 27-9, Trojans. Good hands by John Harper creates a steal. Ahead to Howard Brown, another jam by Brown.
Well, he put a show on down at Lansdale Catholic last Friday night. He threw down five dunks, and they said they had dunks that they haven't seen before. He really did a good job leading the Trojans. A tight game down there. LC really played them tough.
20-point advantage for the Trojans. We are midway through the second quarter. Illig. Looks like he's found his rhythm.
We got to get him shots. There's no question about it. He's their best shooter and scorer on the Phantoms club. They got to find ways to free him up.
29-11. Brown gets to the foul line. He makes it. Howard Brown now has 15 points in the ball game.
Get another look at that jam as Howard Brown looks at the defense a little bit again. He's just elevating so well.
Illig moves in on Ricketts, and he puts it off the glass. Fans want an offensive foul. That's what they're calling for.
We'll give Marcus a lot of credit. He did a pretty good job defensively trying to draw that foul.
Pinson moves in. We've got a whistle, a jump ball.
One more time as Howard looks at the defense a little bit, and it just explodes off the floor. Nothing Illy can do at that point. Again, his head's over the rim there, Dick.
He's staring at the iron.
Boy, I'll say.
Possession hour goes to the Trojans.
They swing the ball. They got an open three for Tommy.
.245 left to play, second quarter.
I really like the way Pottstown's been composed and under control here tonight.
Tom Harvey with the pump fake and then drives the baseline, and he'll get a foul on Brett Illig. Illig picks up his second personal.
No, I think they give that one to Ramsey.
In that case, it's his first personal, Ramsey's. Fourth team foul.
That's my boy Ecky. He got it punched up there for us. Number 30, first team foul.
He's the quickest in the league.
Yes, he is. He's getting better. Who says you can't teach an old dog new tricks? My sixth grade teacher out of Franklin School. Then I took his spot. That was really ironic.
You did?
Yeah, I did. Moved into his sixth grade math class when he retired at the middle school. There he is. I said, cripes on money. He had a whole drawer full of chalk and staplers and stuff. I said, that must be from 1960. Unbelievable shooting performance by the Trojans here in the first half. 61%. Phantoms obviously struggling at 32%.
Tom Ramsey doing some good work on the boards.
And that time he did a good job of keeping the ball high, Dick, so that caused the foul. He did not let the guards double down on him. That foul will be on Brandon Tinson. As again, looks like Harvey has a good position, but you know, Ramsey at 6'5", this jumps right over top of him. You can see Tinson Again, got a little bit of the ball, but got him on the side of the head as well. Tom Ramsey better work on his balance there a little bit. As you can see, he's falling forward. You want to make sure that your feet are about shoulder width apart, and you just foul through with the basketball, wave goodbye to it, and stay there nice and strong on the line. That's much better.
A little strong. Illig fights for the ball, gets it to Adam Blackbird, and stolen by John Harper. Harper feeds Harvey with the left hand. He scores.
Good unselfish play by John Harper. Again, he's really advanced his ball game again here tonight. He's really doing a good job passing, rebounding, shooting the ball.
35-13, Trojans.
He almost drug his pivot foot there a little bit.
That's Brandon Tinson on Brett Illig. Right now, Howard Brown is matched up with Adam Blackburn.
Let Howard rest a little bit defensively.
Joaquin Fordbay, line drive jumper goes in.
I'm sure Coach Davis will let Joaquin shoot them all night long. Joaquin lucky, I didn't think he had that high enough to get over the rim.
Quick hands by Morris. Illig, nice dish to Blackburn, and he scores. Adam Blackburn has his first field goal. It's 35-17.
Tinson's got to keep himself out of that corner. He got trapped up that time.
Phoenixville trying to eke their way back into this contest. Reach-in foul on Fordbay.
Harper doing a good job picking up the steal. Unselfish as Morris gets back well defensively, and you mentioned Tom Harvey doing a great job of going to the left hand and kissing it off the window.
Ben Morgan comes into the ball game, replaces Marcus Ricketts, and Marcus gets a good round of applause.
And he should. He did a nice job inside, pulling down some rebounds, made some good smart plays.
Tom Harvey from the corner drains it. He's got three 3-pointers here tonight, and it's 38-17. Less than a minute to play in the third.
Boy, the way they're shooting tonight reminds me of a couple years ago up at Hershey Park. Man, they stroked the ball all over the place.
Terrell Morris with the fadeaway won't go. Corey Miller keeps it alive, but it comes to Tom Harvey. John Harper on the dish from Harvey, can't score. And Terrell Morris has the rebound with 27 seconds left to play in the quarter. Illig for three, it's off the front of the rim. Tom Harvey to Brandon Tinson to Brown. He can't score it. To Brandon Tinson there for the follow. Tinson now has 6 points.
Howard looks like he got up a little ginger there as he's grabbing the knee. 4 seconds. I don't know if Morris knows or not. He's got to get one off.
At the buzzer, it won't go. And that will end the second quarter. There's your leading scorers. Brett Illig with 9, Miller with 3, Brown with 16, and Tom Harvey with 13. Pretty much as we expected that.
Yeah, it's not real good when you combine the leading scores for Phoenixville and you add them up to 12, and that's less than both Brown and Harvey. You know, Pottstown really playing well defensively in that first period, turned it up offensively in the second period, and really have played well. I think George Rocco's greatest concerns all came true there in that first period when his team came out very, very tight, turned the ball over, missed the easy opportunities, and let Pottstown get into rhythm and get running. And, you know, there's a 23-point lead at halftime. It's going to be very, very tough for Phoenixville to fight back from that deficit here in the second half.
Well, my thoughts exactly, Dave. They did start to find some rhythm in that second quarter, but, boy, Pottstown is a tough team to come back from when you're 23 down.
Well, you know, again, Phoenixville is sitting back in that zone, too, which I think is going to have to change. They're going to have to try to, go to plan B. I'm sure George Rocco wanted to come out and play in his zone and sit back here and make Pottstown beat him from the outside, but Pottstown has done well.
Pottstown comes out in there man-to-man. First shot off the mark. Ben Morgan out on the run. Can't make the layup. Gets his own rebound and then scores high off the glass.
That's good hustle, too, by Ben. He did a great job. He saw Ramsey coming down who had a good opportunity to block a shot, so he goes reverse, misses it, stays with it, and gets the put back. I said, I thought Morgan and Ricketts really played well in that first half for Ken Davis.
Illig working on Howard Brown.
Oh, good steal by Keith Martin.
And Martin will now give it up to Tom Harvey. And Trojans will set up the half-court offense.
And again, Phoenixville's going to stay in that defense.
John Harper in the corner.
He's feeling it.
John Harper now has 8 points in the ball game.
Well, if they can get contributions like they got from Harper and Tinson in that first half, Ken Davis will be ecstatic.
44-17, Trojans. Terrell Morris squares up to the basket, but can't score. Adam Blackburn fights for the rebound and then scores a layup.
Good work by Adam Blackburn. He really had a tough first half. Good to see Adam come back strong.
We've got a whistle underneath.
Hit the wire.
Yeah, no foul. Just the ball went out of bounds. Phoenixville inbound. They trail 44-19. We're a minute and a half into the third quarter.
Blackburn's going to sit down as Chris Neske checks into the ballgame. George Rocco trying to calm Adam down a little bit. Adam trying to do a little bit too much.
Terrell Morris gets in the lane, puts up a shot, and draws the foul.
I think that's John Harper's first foul. And I just heard Ken Davis yell defense. You know, Trojans have a tendency to go out to a big lead and kind of put it in cruise control. And it's tough to put it in cruise control against a team like Phoenixville. You know, they can come back and score in bunches as well. Ken Davis wants to maintain that intensity.
Morris at the line to shoot two.
Yet to score in the ball game, Dick, and I said that was going to be a key matchup for George Rocco, whether Terrell Morris could handle that pressure or run into point against the Trojans and Tom Harvey with his man-to-man pressure. Gets to Cryer.
That is 44-21.
He double dribbled, though. Yep. First half shooting percentages. Pottstown doing a great job of knocking in 16 to 25 for 64%. Phoenixville only hitting one out of three for a 33%. They did a much better job in that second period, though, Dick, because they only had three shots in the first quarter for a long period of time.
Ben Morgan right down the boulevard, can't make it. Corey Miller with a big rebound.
That's a good strong take, too, by Benny. Maybe should have used the glass. It's tough from that angle straight on, whether you go straight in over the front or try to kiss it off the glass, but that was a good strong take.
Brett Illig takes Howard Brown, but can't get it down. The ball was halfway down the bucket, but came out. Trojans come back the other way. Howard Brown floats one up. It's rebounded by Neske.
Howard forced that one, tried to get the foul call, but give Illig a lot of credit for going straight up. Kenny Davis yelling at Tommy Katancic saying, how about a foul out here?
Morris feeds it into Ramsey. Turn around is good. Tom Ramsey has his first field goal in the ball game, and it's 44-22.
Pottstown doing a good job of breaking pressure. A little token pressure by the Phantoms that time. That's a foul.
Corey Miller reaches in front of Ben Morgan. And Corey Miller picks up his second personal foul.
Tom Ramsey getting good post-up position. Ben Morgan doing a good job of holding his own, making Ramsey knock it in over top of you. Sometimes you got to give the offense credit. You know, you play good defense, you stand there and make them shoot over top of you.
Tom Harvey with the three-pointer. It goes in. Tom Harvey has 16 points. He's got 4 three-pointers.
He's feeling it, and he's getting good looks at the basket.
Well, they're attacking the zone very well.
Yes, they are, very smartly.
Corey Miller dishes into Ramsey. Ben Morgan, I think, reaches in and picks up a foul.
That looked like a right half at four there, the old backyard game there. Is Ramsey and Morgan ran into one another as Ramsey tried to make a good, strong cut across the lane. Morgan got there just a second late. Great crowd. These are the kind of crowds we love to see out here every game, Richard.
And my buddy Tim, the postman, he's on camera. I promise him we get him on tonight.
Tim Yergi. Used to wear the striped shirts.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I used to heckle him, too.
He's
used to love to heckle him.
Huge basketball fan.
Oh, he's a great guy.
I 4 minutes left in the third quarter. 47-22 Trojans. Corey Miller gets in the paint, and John Harper picks up another foul.
Harper got a little lazy there, and I think Ken Davis is going to go to the bench. He's going to get Ricketts or Tinson up. Tinson's going to check into the ball game. He doesn't like the defensive lack of intensity. Harper got a little lazy that time, played defense with his hands rather than his feet. Phoenixville cheerleaders have been pretty silent all night.
Neske raises up, can't catch iron, but Tom Ramsey lays it in nicely. He now has 5 points in the ball game. 47-24 is the score. Trojans get out to an early lead, and they've done nothing but expand on that lead. Brown, nice dish to Martin, and he scores, and he's fouled on the play. Keith Martin is in the scorebook.
Tom Ramsey down the other end getting the rebound. Chris Neske is up for the baseline jumper. Nobody boxes out. Howard Brown loses the rhythm, loses the ball.
And Phoenixville calls time. That timeout comes with 3:34 left to play in the third quarter.
Did not see who that foul was on.
It's on Illich.
And again, Howard Brown showing some of his versatility there as he pushes the ball off to the side there. Keith Martin going up strong.
He can elevate, can
he? Yes, he can.
Drive with peace of mind this winter with a new 4x4 Jeep from Norco Motors. The selection of new 95 Jeeps has never been better than right now. And with our convenient lease rates, driving a new Jeep has never been more affordable than right now. Come see for yourself. Check out the selection at Norco Motors, 1055 South Hanover Street in Pottstown.
What are calling for flurries?
We could have a coating when we get up to Martin. More hoop action coming your way on PCTV. This Thursday, we're going to see a girls game over at Boyertown. Wilson at Boyertown, and then a Saturday night game. We'll be back here at the Strom Gymnasium, where Pius will take on Pottstown. And then Tuesday, the 17th, back at Yogi's house again. And O&J comes in to take on the Trojans.
And that scrappy bunch led by Urkel, Costello, and Baraggi. You know, they're doing it with three guys who have really played tough. And when O&J's played well, they're getting some scoring production out of Costello and Urkel. Baraggi knocking in some threes and just playing a good defense, keeping the ball in a low-scoring game and just getting a chance to pull it out at the end. I give Ted Snyder a lot of credit over there in Bucktown this year.
Keith Martin completes a three-point play, and it's now 50-24. Neske thought about the three as the Trojans settle back into their 2-3 zone.
Well, they can afford to play that now with a 25-point lead.
Corey Miller goes along baseline. Good block by Marcus Ricketts. And Tom Ramsey's Johnny on the spot. He's got 6 points here in the third quarter.
Well, Tom Ramsey's got to find a way to get started a little bit earlier in the ball game. He's kind of silent in that first period. Now to start the third period, looks a lot more relaxed, a lot more fresh as he's going strong to the offensive glass.
Tom Harvey, his favorite spot on the court. He now has 15 points from the three-point arc tonight.
Certainly cannot leave him open. I mean, Phoenixville's got to keep a hand in Tom Harvey's face. Give Brandon Tinson a lot of credit for finding the opening and getting him to basketball.
2:30 left in the third quarter. Trojans are up 53-26. There's another guy that Pottstown has kept the wraps on, that being Brett Illich. He had a flurry of points in the second quarter. But other than that, they've kept him under control.
There's Mr. Lindley, Reed Lindley, checking things out. He's a new principal here at Pottstown High School and doing a very fine job. Ex-football coach and athletic director. Checking out his Trojans. I'm sure he's very, very proud of Ken Davis and the job that he does year in and year out.
Long pass over to Brown. He feeds Martin, and Martin has a shot blocked by Ramsey.
Got to take it right to the shot blocker. He cannot fade away a little bit. That's where he can extend his long arms. Ramsey doing a good job there, getting ball.
Harvey strips Morris, saves it ahead to Brandon Tinson.
That's his great individual effort right there by Tom Harvey. That's why that guy, as I said before, is the premier point guard in the area, bar none.
And the crowd shows their approval. Howard Brown, three-pointer from the corner, rims out. Kept alive by Marcus, and Harvey's has his shot rejected by Brett Illy.
Boy, there's a lot of bodies inside, isn't there? Here's Keith Martin again, getting a good dish inside. So he kind of double pumps it there, lets the shot blocker, gets his arm extended. You got to take it right through the shot blocker's chin. Tried the alley-oop off the inbounds. Howard just couldn't get it to drop.
Didn't quite go down. 1:10 left in the third quarter. ...53-26. Marcus Ricketts steps in front of the entry pass, and the Trojans have the ball, and Neske commits a foul in frustration. Chris Neske picks up his first personal.
Tom Harvey does a good job of talking to Keith Martin, said don't let that bother you, can't let anything distract you, take you out of your ball game. Chris Neske will take a seat on the bench, and you mentioned that was a frustration foul.
Adam Blackburn replaces him in the Phoenixville lineup.
He's had a tough ball game. I'd like to see Adam get going here a little bit. Nice kid, good player. Just struggling a little bit here tonight. Howard Brown has been shut out here in the second half.
Keith Martin gets the loose ball, puts it up and in. Keith Martin has 5 points here in the third quarter, and it's 55-26.
Another product of that feeder system.
Corey Miller has his shot blocked. Joaquin Fordbay is there.
Nice take, Joaquin, as he ripped that one right out from underneath a couple Trojans and put it back in the hole. Good work by the big guy. I think that's what George Rocco wants to see out of Joaquin, not three-pointers at the top of the key.
Harvey dishes back to Brandon Tinson at the buzzer. Does not catch iron, and that will end the third quarter. Fourth quarter here at Strom Gymnasium, 55-28 Trojans. Still a tough job to come in here and beat the Trojans on their home court.
You know, and one of the things I don't think Ken Davis gets enough credit for is his kids get up and play hard every ball game. You know, we said that O&J did a great job coming in and knocking off Phoenixville down at Phoenixville, but then they turn around and the next night they lose to Pius, who hasn't had a very good successful season this year. You know, so that's one thing I think that's overlooked sometimes is that Kenny gets these guys to play hard every ball game, and very rarely we see them get upset in a ball game. They may get beat by a better ball club, as we've seen over the years, but very rarely do they lose in the league on an off night.
Tom Harvey forces one up, kept alive by John Harper. It comes to Brandon Tinson.
They want to get Brandon another shot from that corner spot.
He feeds Marcus, who wasn't ready for it.
Probably sound a little ragged in their zone offense right now, Tom. He's got to get him into something. Move the ball around.
Of course, they can afford to take time off the clock.
Absolutely. You know, Phoenixville sitting back in a soft 2-3 zone.
Harvey feeds Marcus, and Marcus will lay it in. Marcus Ricketts in the scoring column, but his contribution tonight has been other places than in the scorebook.
And I tell you, when you're playing with Tom Harvey, you always have to have your hands ready for the basketball as he gets it to you when you're open. Again, there's another good rebound by Marcus.
Harvey feeds Brown coming down the lane, and his shot is rejected by Corey Miller. Corey Miller got a lot of ball, but he picks up his third personal foul.
That's got to be Coach Rocco. Had some recent foot surgery there. He likes to wear some sneakers to keep his feet comfortable. There you get another look at the block as Howard Brown did a good job of cutting the lane. Miller does a good job of getting ball, but he gets a lot of body with it as well. As you can see the arm coming across the face there.
Lower your home heating bills with the competitive price of J.L. Campbell. Plus, you can save money too. Pay when your fuel oil is delivered and J.L. Campbell passes the savings on to you. J.L. Campbell offers prompt delivery, fast emergency service at competitive prices. Get the fuel oil you need from the name in fuel oil, J.L. Campbell at 326-6287.
Wow. Pottstown finest. You can tell it's a big game.
That's Dave's mom there.
Yeah.
Right in the center of your screen. Well, she got a good seat tonight, too, right behind the bench.
That's the card club. Those girls all play
cards.
Is that
what that is? Oh,
yeah, that's a bridge club. Don't get a whole lot of cards done, I don't think. A lot of talking, a lot of fooling around. But a little bit of cards here and there, I guess. Yvonne Strum and Nancy Chumnuck, my mother.
This is Howard's first trip to the line tonight. He makes the first, now has 16 points. As Dave mentioned, he was held scoreless in the third period.
But again, he dished the ball well. He got rebounds. He ran the floor, played good defense against Brett Illig as he shut Brett Illig out in the third period as well.
This is Adam Blackburn from the corner. He's been struggling tonight with his shot. Brett Illig.
There's Illig.
Knocks one down. His first bucket since the second quarter. He's got 11 in the contest. 59-30, Trojans.
Very patient, Trojans are. Well coached. Look at Marcus feeling it.
His three-pointer is strong, and Corey Miller skies for the board. Did Corey Miller have that knee brace on the last time we saw him?
I don't remember him having that. I was just looking at that myself.
He still gets up pretty good. He's got brace on both knees. There's a Pottstown bench. I'd like to keep an eye on that scoreboard. Margin of victory is adequate. They may see some action.
Good to see Mary Powell over there, too. We talked about Mary getting recent back surgery, and she's up and about already. Tough bird. Loves her basketball. Files her son, Whitaker, on the Pottsgrove Junior or High School JV program. Loves the Trojans out here. Graduate of Pottstown High. Teacher in the middle school. Good to see Mary out here.
Keith Martin stepped before he dribbled.
There they are, chatting with Linda Davis. Mary on the right there. You can see, it looks like she has a big back brace on. Also, Mrs. Morgan, Ben's mother. A lot of loyal people to the Pottstown basketball program. Reverend Acker's back there. I'm surprised he doesn't have his camera out there. Oh, I think it might be hanging from
his
neck.
He's got a camera around his neck. Illig nearly create a backcourt violation.
Good defense by John Harper as Anthony Thomas checks into the ball game.
He injects a little bit of speed into the lineup. Very quick.
I thought he might get a little call earlier when he needed that shot of enthusiasm or spark or something.
John Harper launches a three from the corner.
That's been rebound. A bad spot. They better get out of that corner spot.
Ball dribbles out of bounds, and that belongs to the Trojans.
I think Phoenixville retained possession.
Phoenixville ball.
Yep.
Okay. Illig wasn't ready for the pass. Goes out of bounds.
Well, when it rains, it pours, and you know it's a helpless feeling for George Rocco over there on the bench.
Howard Brown with another jam. Gets behind the defense.
Cannot turn your back on the Trojans. You got to hustle back defensively.
Trojans now up by 31, 61-30. 4:20 left to play. Five white jerseys at the scorer's table. Illig from the foul line, off the heel of the rim. Anthony Thomas takes the three. He can't score it. Brown rebounds. Howard dishes Keith Martin. He can't score.
Good hustle back by Tom Ramsey. He shut the lane off very quickly there. Martin got a shot blocked earlier. That was in the back of his mind. You can't worry about that. You got to keep taking it up strong.
Ramsey goes along baseline. He draws the foul. Marcus Ricketts fouls him.
Howard doing a good job of avoiding Adam Blackburn. Gets off the floor for his third dunk of the night. Howard Brown doing a good job of trying to set up Keith Martin. He draws defense, but look at Ramsey getting back real well defensively. As the Trojans will get a good, well-deserved rest on the bench. A lot of the youngsters in this ball game. They came to play tonight. No question about it. Ken Davis had him ready.
Dimitri Smith, Dave Pascal, Tom Harling, Phil Day,
Warren Ford.
Warren Ford on the floor for the Trojans. As Tom Ramsey.
It's now 2 for 4 from the stripe. 50%er.
And he's now got 9 points in the contest. 61-32, Pottstown. Chris Neske creates a steal and converts it at the other end. Chris Neske has his first field goal, and it's 61-34.
Pottstown reserves have to protect the basketball against his pressure.
And Phoenixville stays in that zone defense. Warren Ford shuffles the feet before he dribbles the foot to the basketball, and the Trojans turn it over.
Coach Davis yells at Warren, make sure you run the offense, Warren. Don't try to get too much French pastry doing things on your own. Stay within the system, you'll get your shots.
Neske dishes it into Ramsey. He turns to the bucket, puts it up there nice and soft. And it's 61-36. Inside of 3 minutes to play in the ball game. Phil Day travels with the basketball. And another violation by the Trojans.
Well, he substitutes, better start playing well. There's going to be more substitutions. Ken Davis does not like lack of performance and lack of execution. Gets very, very angry. Whether you're a front liner or one of the last guys on the club, you better perform.
Neske throws up an air ball that's rebounded by Phil Day. Phoenixville still playing hard, going for the steals. Pascal gets in the paint, throws one up. Rebound comes to Warren Ford. And a foul on Neske.
Well, Pascal did a good job of stepping in there. He saw an opening in the zone, stepped in, just couldn't get the shot to drop. Warren Ford did a good job of going for the rebound. Now gets an opportunity from the charity stripe.
And, of course, we get to that two-minute mark in the fourth quarter, and we think about our Lubbock Motors player of the game.
I know who mine is.
I got one lined up, too. I think we're thinking about the same guy, Dave.
I'm thinking of the point guard for the Trojans. He's a guy that really got him started.
I'm thinking number 32.
Absolutely. 5 threes. Did a great job, 19 points. Led the attack, and, you know, Tom Harvey, this is a spectacular ball game for the Trojans here tonight.
And the player of the game is brought to you by Lubbock Motors, 3rd and Hanover Streets in Pottstown. ...62-36, Thomas feeds Ramsey, fouled from behind by Dimitri Smith.
Here we get a good look at our Ludwig Motors player to ball game, and Tom Harvey has been very, very steady, very consistent, comes to play every night. Talking to his buddy, Batman, on the sideline there.
I hope that's a temporary tattoo.
That's what I keep telling these kids, you know, they don't wash off, you know, they're going to be there forever.
Ramsey getting to the line quite a few times here in the contest. He's 4-4 here in the fourth quarter from the line. Good sign that guy his size gets to the free throw line. 1:45 left to play in the ballgame.
There's a shot from Meter Smith. They want it.
Warren Ford will take the shot. Can't get it down. Run down by Anthony Thomas. Boy, he is quick.
Well, I'll say. Good sense for the ball, too. Good nose for that basketball.
Puts up a shot. Rebound comes to Phil Day. Phil will push it up the floor.
Why not? Get in there.
Blackburn saves it into Neske. 62-38 Trojans. As we mentioned, they get out to an early lead. And Phoenixville could never quite get into the ball game after that.
Look at Nesky, though. I'll tell you, he hasn't stopped hustling.
Nesky with the left-hand reverse layup. That's a nice shot.
Coach Davis would be very upset with his second team was here. They haven't been protecting the basketball very well. Turning the ball over. There's a shot.
Pascal will take it off the back of the rim. Tom Harling rebounds and then is stripped by Anthony Thomas. The ball dribbles out of bounds with 30 seconds left on the clock.
And the Trojans will remain undefeated here in the Pac-10 as they jump up to 9-0 and really send a message to the Phantoms here tonight.
Pascal's three-pointer is just short. Anthony Thomas gets it ahead to Nesky. Nesky goes in on Warren Ford and scores his sixth point of the fourth quarter. And again, Nesky on the layup. That is 62-44 with 2 seconds left. And that will end the contest. All Pottstown tonight, 62-44 on the Spence Ford scoreboard, and that's a final. The Trojans come out on top and remain undefeated in the Pac-10. And today we talked at the top of the show about defense. And of course, Phoenixville comes out in his zone defense, and Tom Harvey almost beat it single-handedly.
Yeah, he sure did. I mean, they left him open on that wing in the 2-3 zone. Pottstown was very patient with the ball, reversed it, got the ball over there to Harvey behind the three-point line, and he knocks in five of them.
We also mentioned, it seems game in, game out, about the Trojans' effort, a four-quarter effort, and again, we saw it again tonight.
No question about it. You know, Tom Harvey, they're still winning by 27, 29 points. Harvey's diving on the floor for loose balls, trying to throw the ball inside of somebody to get a layup going the other way. And that's the thing I think that separates the Trojans from a lot of these other teams, the fact that they come out and play hard every night for four quarters.
But we're at the halfway point of the Pac-10 season, and it appears certainly that Trojans are one of the teams to beat and should certainly be in the Final Four. But Phoenix are also going to be there, but they've got to make some improvements in their team also.
Well, you know what? George Rocco's worst scenario came true in the first quarter. They came out very, very tight. They were short on shots. They turned the ball over. They couldn't get the ball inside to their big people. And they just really got off to a bad start, and they never were able to recover from that. I'm sure George Rocco will go back and reassess things, maybe look at the fact that they played that 2-3 zone rather than coming out and trying to force the action, maybe play a little man, get something going to get back into the ball game. And that's what coaching is all about, making adjustments, and I'm sure we'll have another strategy next time the two teams play.
Okay, again, it's 62-44. Trojans come out on top tonight. Don't forget, Thursday night we'll be at Boyertown to see Wilson and Boyertown in some girls' action. But again, tonight, this is Dick Geiger along with Dave Ridenour. Good night, everybody. Thanks for watching.
Just in case.
Hey, yo, we back. It's your boy Big Star Ross, Big Star Ross Sports, man. Lost tapes, you know what I'm saying? I hope y'all enjoyed that classic. Yo, Brown, it was dope, man. It was crazy, dog.
Monstrous, you know, just looking at that beat, man. We either go hard or find something. I tell people every time, man, to be able to come and pack out a gym like that. I mean, I played with guys for years, professionals that never had it like that until they became professionals, man. We had it in high school every weekend, man. That's definitely, you know, love right there. But, you know, you can't get ugly if you're not coming in there prepared, you know.
Especially in a little gym like that, like, you know what I'm saying, where it's packed out, y'all super comfortable. It ain't nothing like a small gym to just catch wreck and just get busy. Hey, quick question for you, man, just totally off topic. Like, Like, when did you, like, did you always jump that high, dog? Like, I mean, like you, the one dunk during the game, like, you cocked it back almost to the numbers in the back of your jersey, and, like, your legs were, like, just all just contorted, and it was like you were just in the air for a few minutes, dog. Like, when did you, like, where did that come from?
Yeah, that's a good case of genetics, and also a good case of, you know that drill that you said, you know, staying on the steps and do the cat raises.
That's old school. Ooh, I like that. That's old school right there.
Every day on my steps, you know, one leg, two leg, jump and roll.
Yo, listen, Brown, listen. I don't mean to cut you off, but you know, these days, like, you know, basketball has totally evolved and it's changed from what we remember. You know what I'm saying? Like, these days you got, like, you know, kids that are like 6-7 year olds going to personal trainers and, you know, going to these, like it's serious now. But back in the day, all we had was the steps at the crib. You know what I'm saying? We was getting our calf raised on. Like, that's old school working out right there. That's old school, man. And it gets it done. You know what I mean?
That's it. And even if, you know, the best trainers, man, they still work some of that stuff in there, man, because they know it works. They know it works. You know, you work out with enough guys, you can still see them sprinkling a little bit of that raw steel building in there, man. So, you can't ever leave that, man. That's where it all started.
That's what's up. Hey, real quick, something that I think is super important, man. Something that I definitely want to highlight and share with the people. You're a part of a company, iBall United. If you can, explain to the people what iBall United is, what you're doing for the sports culture, and and then top it off with if it's somebody watching this film who says, yo, that's exactly what I was looking for. I need them to help me out. How could they get, you know, where did it need to go?
Yeah, absolutely, man. You know, so iBall United is a sports agency, right? Full service sports agency, but really much, much more. You know, in my personal experience, when I came out, like I said before, I bounced around a lot of leagues, really couldn't find my way to making it pro. So I had a lot of questions, man. How to find that agent? You know, how to find the right agent? How do I work with that agent? And from, you know, there to the contracts, what does that look like? You know, we don't really get schooled on that kind of stuff in school, right? So, you know, we actually made our website similar to, like, a monster.com. So, you know, but for sports. So if you go to iBallUnited.com, it's a place where players and personnel can connect, and as agents and coaches, of course, they can have a contract to offer. But you're also going to find, you know, a lot of information about the best tryout, the best workout, even trainers. And video editors, anywhere you can go looking for a service that's being offered for the advancement and betterment of your career, that's where you can go with iBall United.
That's what's up, man. So what's the name of the website, and you know, to get involved, what's the information or any information you want the people to have?
Yeah, definitely. It's iBall United. So that's the letter iBallUnited.com. And go there, shoot us some contact information, shoot a quick survey, see where you're at, we're going to assess it, and we're going to try to match you up with the best fit, whether that's a camp trial or directly with an agent. And really, at the same time, you register and you'll go find your own way. You know, a lot of players know what they need or they're just trying to figure it out. So, you know, go explore and we're going to do whatever we can to help you take that next step, play at the highest level.
Hey, that's what's up, Brown. That's truly a blessing, man. God bless you guys for what it is that you do. I mean, you definitely basically, you know, took your own personal experience, identified a need, and you filled that need. And it's basically like you're just, you know, helping people to not, go through the same hurdles that you experienced. You know what I'm saying? Making the way a lot easier for a lot of people out here. So you guys are definitely a blessing to a lot of people, man. So, you know, much blessings to you guys and your company and what it is that y'all do. And here at Big Star Raw Sports, man, I'm gonna help you out any way I can. I'm gonna try to send as many people to the website as I can, dog. It's a done deal. Hey, one last thing, man. Any shout outs, any old teammates, anybody you want to give some love to before we close out?
Yeah, definitely. Michael Walker, my man John Sullivan, and definitely my man Terrell Stokes. I can go on and on, man. Tony Savine with the Pro Fender, my man Steve Daggs. Like I said, we can go on and on, man. But my big homie, Jason Robinson overseas, this guy, you know, he's living proof that, you know, NAIA school, find your way, get in Portugal, and now you're playing in what a lot of people consider the best league, you know, outside of NBA in the world, and just leading the score, killing it. So, you know, the dream can be real. You just gotta know how to go get it and work towards it, and I'll start the raw sports, baby.
Hey, Brown, God bless you, man. I'm so happy that we was able to connect, dog. And, you know, the sky's the limit for us, man. It's definitely going to be more opportunities. You know, we're definitely going to be hanging out, man, doing a lot more cool things together. You know, God is good, man. I just appreciate, you know, this opportunity to have some fun with you, man. You know, strictly representing the old school, dog.
You know it, man. Thank you.
All right, Brown. Hey, you take care, big dog. I'm going to get this. Oh, one last thing. Yo. Oh, I can't forget. Hold up. Got your Raw Sports t-shirt right here with your name on it. The Howard Brown exclusive Raw Sports is definitely, this is for you, big homie. It's coming in the mail for you. It's coming in express mail. I'm holding up a Raw Sports t-shirt. It's yours. It's coming in the mail. I'm sending your lost tapes back to you on Monday morning. The t-shirt's coming. You said you were XL. I got you, big homie.
Oh, man, that's a beautiful thing right there, man. I'm gonna rock down for pride, let everybody know. Where it all started, where it all came from, and like I told you, man, I got a crate full of archives, man. So if it works like that, we give you the archives. I get the love with a hot shirt, and we can keep doing this all day.
Hey, Brown, if what you're saying is Big Star can get access to the vault, hey, Brown, I am forever indebted, dog. And listen, just so you know, they've crowned me the Fred Sanford of sports archives, dog. Like, I'm a archive hoarder. I didn't think that it existed, but I'm a basketball game hoarder, dog. Like, the archives go on and on, dog. So I appreciate your contribution to the movement. God bless you, man. And I look forward to more lost tapes featuring Howard Brown and Pottstown, man.
You know it, man. God bless you, man. We'll talk soon.